If I could describe Black History Month in one word, I'd describe it as a celebration.
Amplification.
Inspirational.
Welcome to Black History Month. Hello, hello people. What's good? What's good? My name is Bacar and I study business and marketing.
I'm Sali and I am a journalism student.
My name is Fatma Ali and I'm studying law at the University of Westminster.
I'm Humera and I'm a third year biomedical science student at the University of Westminster.
Black History Month to me gives us an opportunity to learn about our history, regardless of what age you are.
It puts blackness back into history where it belongs, in the UK, in the US, and all over the world. Black people have been making really significant contributions to history that unfortunately just aren't spoken about and just aren't taught about in the curriculum.
Black history and culture is a lot more extensive than what we may have learned in class.
We didn't get a chance to learn about our black history, and since the diaspora is often spread out all over the world, it's gives us a chance to connect.
It's a celebration of being black. It's a celebration of the people that came before us, that paved the way for us to be where we are today as black people. And I also think it's important because it inspires us to dream big, to think bigger and better of ourselves, to know that we also can influence and impact the world just as the people before us did as well.
I think it's important for all of us to really participate in these conversations and take them really seriously, to try and learn and expand our minds so that we can have the kind of future that, you know, we want to have, where these gaps are just brought that little bit closer. And I think that's what Black History Month does.
Netflix is a great source of information to learn about Black history, especially the more positive Black history that we were hidden from.
If you're really into films, it's really important to try and support black directors or films with predominantly black casts or black interest stories.
Films like Hidden Figures are amazing because it's biographical and it's about three black women who were mathematicians at NASA during the space race in the 50s and the 60s, and they did a great deal of work and had a pivotal role in the space race.
The past few months, I think there was already a raised awareness about racism, but people are now actively sharing more, and I think there's a lot of great infographics which I actually learned a lot from, which are being posted on Facebook, on Instagram. There's a lot to view in sort of that respect, and also through university events, especially with Black History Month, there's a lot of events going on virtually.
I think one of the most essential resources the UK needs is actually to include it in the curriculum. Now, I know in history we've all learned about slavery, but how much black history do we actually know? Not very much. Aside from slavery, there is a rich, in-depth, intense and beautiful history behind black people and behind black British people as well. So I feel like that is one of the most important and essential resources that we can use in order to push the topic of black history.
I love music from across the African continent. So if I was to change the Google Doodle, I would have a Google Doodle of Umu Sangare. She's a Malian musician who did a lot for women's rights in Mali and across Africa.
I would change it to an electric guitar, and I change it in honor of Sister Rosetta Tharpe, who was a black woman who was the pioneer of rock and roll as we know it today. So everyone from Elvis Presley to Eric Clapton was inspired by this woman, so I think I would change it to an electric guitar just for her.
I think I would actually pick a snippet from Black is King, Beyoncé's visual album. I feel like it is something that has marked history for life. It is something very modern, but I do actually think it is something that has influenced a lot of young black people. We all love Beyoncé, we all know she is an icon, she is a legend, but quite literally, I feel as though she has made history with her latest visual album.